The High Court on Thursday expressed its sorrow after so many people died between the 2 a.m. to 6 a.m. corridor. The court has, in its order dated May 12, asked the state government to ensure that there are no more casualties due to shortage of oxygen.
The government attributed the late night deaths to logistical issues involved in maneuvering the tractor which carries the trolleys of oxygen and in connecting the cylinders to the manifold. The court asked the health secretary to file a status report by tomorrow 6 p.m. by email, and that if they were not satisfied with the status report, further proceedings would be held on Saturday, May 15th, or else the court will continue hearing the matter on Monday, May 17th.
It is the High Court's intervention, I believe, that has massively impacted this problem. Today's hearing mostly was regarding the concern regarding the oxygen crunch, which is faced at GMC. Now, despite orders passed yesterday, there were some deaths due to oxygen crunch that was noticed. So, because of this, the High Court wanted to know what is the exact situation and what are the remedies that can be done. So, now we have moved an application for making certain more parties in the matter. That is, we have asked for Govindpur Oxygen Scoop, SA Oxynitro Private Limited and Kumkolim Oxygen to be made parties. Now, since these people are the major suppliers of oxygen, maybe they will be also able to chip in and help how better supply of oxygen can be made to GMC and other hospitals in order to ensure that there are no deaths as far as oxygen shortage is concerned. Now, super specialty block has a capacity of about 500 beds. And I believe it is not running at full capacity. There are some works pending. So we've made this company a party, which is HHC India Limited, and they are constructing this project. So they will also be able to better inform the court how fast they can hand over this building, because what we are looking at is next going to happen is the impending third wave, which could affect largely a significant portion of the population. So before that, we need all these arrangements in place. I wouldn't say satisfied as far as the outcome is concerned in terms of reduction of deaths. Even one life lost because of oxygen crunch would make me to say otherwise. But I believe what the court has taken enough effective steps, and the court is ensuring that every possible measure is explored, every possible solution is arrived at to make sure that this problem is non-existent to some extent. I could not have asked for any better orders that have been passed today or in these matters over the last 3-4 days that the court has been hearing. The court has been hearing the matter also continuously, and also expressed that they will sit on Saturday if the need be. We've just informed during the hearing that the union government has increased the LMO quota, which was I believe around 21 metric tons, to about 46 metric tons. In addition to that, we have local production of about 15 metric tons. So that right now may scale to about 56 metric tons, which will help the severe oxygen crunch that we are facing. The other issue is regarding those Dura cylinders that were fitted. I believe they have still not been able to optimally use them. That issue is still before how Scoop, that is the agency which is looking after installation of the cylinders, is going to install it properly and make sure it's working. During the hearing, there was counsel appearing on behalf of Scoop, who also addressed on this issue. The High Court has directed the state government to notify it about what is the progress of all these hearings that has taken place all this while, and to inform them by tomorrow. In case the situation is not good or it worsens further, the High Court may even sit on Saturday and hear the matter. And if not, otherwise the matter is kept on Monday to see further how these issues can be solved.
The government told the court that they will stop trolleys and fit a pressurized system to stop the dip in oxygen pressure.
One positive thing that came out of this hearing is that now the government is going to discontinue with the trolley system of oxygen supply at GMC, and they are fitting a pressurized or an LMO tank, which they have procured from Praxair, I believe, which is at Bicholim, and which is now going to be fitted in GMC. So that may solve this whole problem where the trolleys come in.
Fluctuation problems.
Fluctuation problems, exactly. So fluctuation basically happens when there is a switchover. And this happens apparently every 25 minutes. But the maximum impact of the switchover is felt during the night when there are, usually about 15 to 20 deaths that have taken place. A single person should have died for the lack of oxygen. There are other factors which influence, which are beyond even doctors' hands. But severe crunch of oxygen and people dying because of that is something not actually acceptable. So even the High Court was quite sensitive about this issue. In fact, the judges apologized that, despite whatever efforts High Court is taking, these deaths still took place.
What the government told the court: Dura cylinders will be positively installed and made operational at the GMC today itself. 323 oxygen concentrators are being flown into the state and will be available for use at GMC by today itself. Oxygen storage tank to be installed at GMC by May 17th. Once this tank is installed, the issue of uninterrupted supply of oxygen will be sorted out to a great extent, they promised. Central government has increased the oxygen quota. William Rodericks for Goa 365.